Well, I'm here with Mr. Globetrotter. We're back out. We're at the... Where are we, Mr. Globetrotter?
Riverside Museum.
Riverside Museum. We're about to walk the... What's it called? The Kelvin side walk from Kelvin Dale or something in Glasgow. Tomogai, pretty much the way the West Highland Way should start. Is that right, Mr. Globetrotter?
That's correct.
I think we've got lost somewhere. I don't think this is the right way. Is it?
I don't think so. I think
we've gone back in time or something.
Yeah, I think so.
Probably just get the train then. What time does it depart? What time's it departing at?
It's departing very shortly.
Jason, that's not even a real train.
Is it not?
Aye, Jason, Mr. Globetrotter, yeah. That was definitely the wrong way.
It was.
Not going to get us where we're going. Yeah. Well, I think we've found the path now. I think we took the wrong path and ended up walking through the Riverside Museum. But we're down by the river now. So we're following this path now, the Riverside path. The Kelvin, the River Kelvin, is it the River Kelvin? Eh? Is it the River Kelvin, aye? Yeah, so we're following the river up to Milngavie. So if you're ever wanting to walk the West Highland Way and start from Glasgow, you would take this route here and you would follow the Kelvin, River Kelvin. It's about 10 miles according to Walk Highlands, the Walk Highlands website. Aye, okay, mister. I think we heard you the first time. Aye, so this is where you would head. You would head for Kelvin Grove Park and then towards Maryhill Locks, towards the Fourth and Clyde Corral. And that'll take you to the first 3 miles of the walk. Just across the museum, the Kelvin, what's the museum called?
Kelvin Grove and Art
Gallery. Kelvin Grove Art Gallery is just behind us there, so it's going this way now. Crossing the river, I think this is the Kelvin again, and we're crossing it now. Lovely. Hello!
Hello!
Yeah, so we're just walking down the Kelvindale route and some fine pictures here along this housing area here. Some pretty decent artwork. Get that quite a bit in Glasgow. So here we are on the Kelvin Walkway. And here's, I don't know what this bridge is called. Do you know what this bridge is called?
River Kelvin.
I know it's the River Kelvin. I think we established that much, yeah. But I don't know what bridge it is. It looks like that one in Edinburgh, doesn't it? Is there one like that in?
Oh, across the Waverley.
Aye. Is it built by that Telford guy?
Maybe.
He builds all the bridges, doesn't he? Thomas Telford. Don't think it was him though, I don't know. Probably not this time. You're not on Snapchat again, are you?
What?
You're not back on Snapchat again?
No.
Never off that bloody thing. So basically, if you're doing the West Highland Way, you can start at Kelvin Grove and walk the first 10 miles from Kelvin Grove up to Milngavie along the Kelvin River. Is that right, Mr. Globetrotter?
Kelvin.
The River Kelvin.
Does that go all the way to Milngavie, sir?
Well, no, you come off, it goes so far and then you come off the river and then change path, but it still takes you to Milngavie, you know. So I think that makes more sense, does it not? Starting from Kelvin Grove rather than Milngavie, you know? Do you know what I mean? Yeah?
Yeah.
I think it makes more sense. So in future, if I'm doing the West Highland Way, I'm going to start from Kelvin Grove, add on an extra 10 miles. Ooh, scary. So that's all said, just passing through the Windford area now. The Windford area of Glasgow. Just before we reach Maryhill locks, where the TV programme Still Game is filmed. That'll be coming up next. This is Windford. So what do you think of Windford, Mr. Globetrotter?
All right, it's rather...
Did you not see it was a bit of a dodgy area?
Well, it's dodgy.
What's dodgy?
Dodgy area.
Can you finish your sentence before you start the next one?
It's dodgy because you're here.
No, can you finish this? That's not the reason it's dodgy. But never mind, doesn't matter.
There's a thing for Celtic.
Celtic? I wouldn't mention Celtic. They'll get beaten up. So we're heading through this way now, just crossed the road. Now we've got, how long now? Maryhill locks. 2 minutes about Maryhill. Still got well, 35 minutes till we get to Milngavie. Right, stop dilly dallying about.
Buckfast,
where? Yeah. Buckfast makes you fuck fast, apparently. Book fast in the right place. Are you a Celtic fan? Yeah?
No. Oh, sorry, yeah.
You are a Celtic fan. Make up your mind, you either are or you aren't.
I don't like Rangers.
You can't like both. You don't like Rangers. Well, there's going to be a few disappointed people on YouTube, and there'll be a few people that also be impressed as well. So Mr. Globetrotter likes Celtic. Yeah?
Yeah.
Me, myself, I don't really give a crap about football. I don't really support any team. So I don't have to risk getting beaten up by the other team because I don't give a crap about footy. Is that right, Mr. Globetrotter?
Mm-hmm, that's right.
Mr. Yeah?
That is correct, Mr. Hill.
That's the one. Aye, so what's this over here then, Mr. Globetrotter?
That's the Ford from Clyde Canal.
Just up here?
There, yeah.
Aye, that's the canal runs over there. It's a bit weird having a canal on top of a bridge, because what happens if the bridge burst and all the water came down, the whole canal would drain out, wouldn't it?
Yeah,
along the paths. I'll show you a view of the canal from the other side. I'll just do a switch over to that. This is the view you get if you're up the top of the canal. So yeah, this is the actual Kelvin crossover bridge here. This canal This is a canal, and it's the Forth and Clyde Canal. It's built up over the top of the Kelvin Walkway and the River Kelvin. If you just look over here, this is where we were yesterday. We were walking along that path, and that's where we were walking. And this is the Forth and Clyde Canal on top of the bridge. So if it just happened, the bridge happened to break, then all the water would fall out of here onto the Kelvin Walkway and would go everywhere, and Glasgow would be flooded, basically. Quite annoying, this, actually. So we're like, we're about halfway now, I think. Halfway to Milngavie, are we?
Mm-hmm.
Did you ever fancy yourself as a celebrity?
Oh, definitely.
Did you see yourself as an actor when you were at school? Did you always want to be
stupid all the time?
Ah, you were acting stupid all the time.
Like nothing new there.
Did you want to be a clown when you left school?
I'm a clown.
Oh, okay. Where's your red nose? Where's your red nose?
No, but you'll have a red nose in a minute.
Oh shit! See you later. So we've reached Mary Hill Road here. This road, Mary Hill Road, stretches for about 7 miles apparently. So you turn up here onto Mary Hill Park and go through Mary Hill Park. Still heading towards Milngavie. We've got about... wait a minute, why does that say 2 hours?
That's what it takes to Milngavie.
Oh, I thought the other side did 20 minutes.
Another 14, because this is the Kelvin
road. Oh, right, okay, yeah, so we've got another 2 hours to go yet, then we reach Milngavie. We'll go up through Mary Hill Park, hopefully we won't get mugged or abducted or anything like that. Hey, Mr. Globetrotter.
Yes, sir.
What are you doing there?
I'm just doing a wee Snapchat update.
More Snapchat?
Oh, yeah, why?
Is that all you do?
That's all I do, yeah. If they don't like it, they can delete me.
Aye, I'm going to delete you when I get back. Fed up here on your Snapchat all the time. It's not Snapchat, it's Facebook. Right, so we're now just past a place called Acer or Acre. I don't know how you pronounce it, spelled Acer. Just past Acer now. Just following this fence line now back to the River Kelvin. Where is he? Come on, Mr. Globetrotter. You're lagging behind. You don't get your... How are your shoes doing?
Well, they're a bit kind of dirty.
It's only a bit of mud.
Still.
No need to be a Jesse about it.
What do you say, you prick?
Come on. Calm down, wait a minute.
Prick!
I didn't mean it. Oh. Right, I'm not coming near you now. I didn't know you were aggressive like that, Mr. Globetrotter. Psycho. Total psychopath, him. Not going near him. Keeping my distance. Nearly got me in the mud.
Don't be a stick in the mud, Mr. Hill.
I'm not sticking the mud, I'm just keeping my distance from people like you. I knew there was folk in Glasgow like that, but I didn't know you were one of them. Hello, Mr. Ed, the talking horse. What have you got to say for yourself today, then? Eh? Anything to say? Nothing to say. Just another day. Oh well, nothing much. We'll just press on. What's that?
It'll be dark for the time we walk back, won't it?
I don't think so. It's light till about 8, half 8 now, isn't it? Well, we're in the... that's us in the country now, basically, isn't it? Still following the Kelvin. But we're basically in the... out in the country now, aren't we? Getting near Milngavie, eh?
Mm-hmm.
So I think in the future, if I'm doing the West Highland Way, I'll probably start from from the town and just walk through Kelvin Grove. Isn't that right, Mr. Globetrotter?
Yes, that's correct.
Yep, so we're here now, we're just past the Kelmont Golf Course there. I don't know if you can see that very well. Now we're heading up further up the River Kelvin. Can't really do this very well, just move it up. This is the Walk Highlands description I'm following here. Mm-hmm. So just up here, still got a bit to go yet. Up here, follow that blue line. Eventually we should arrive at Milngavie in time for tea. Milngavie. Right, so I'll keep following that and the little dot shows us where we're going. I recommend Walk Highlands if you've never discovered it before. Great for walks, and then you just click on the wee map and the little dot, show you the little dot. It's back here somewhere. There, the little dot. That little dot there. So that shows you where you are, and you just, it keeps you on track. So thanks to Walk Highlands for that description. Actually, the description though, you know, it's better following the map. If you just read the description, it's no good, because obviously things change, your surroundings change over the years and it gets mixed up and all that. So yeah, there's a set back at the road, River Kelvin. So I just think it's basically just going to cross the road at Milngavie Woods, cross over here and back onto the path on the other side. Is that right, Mr. Globetrotter?
That's correct, sir.
And here. Are you wanting to have a pint when you reach Milngavie? If we make it there at a reasonable time, it's 6 o'clock now. We need to get back as well, so we're going to walk back. I don't know, maybe we'll get a bus. Hello there, Mr. Cow, or Mrs. Cow. Is it Mrs. Cow? That one's scared, I think. So, how have you been? Are you having a good Friday evening near Milngavie? Do you like it here? Are you having a good day? Have you lived here long? No? No? No, nothing to say at all? Just keep moving? Well, keep moving. Keep moving, okay. Fair enough. We're just about there. Are we almost there? Well, we've got our first view of Milngavie in the distance now. There must be about a mile or a mile and a half to go now. We can see it there on the skyline. It took us ages. We're not quite there yet, but it really did take longer than we thought it would take. It's nearly 7 o'clock now, and we started at about half one. Two, three, four, five. Yeah, it took us about 5 hours. So is that Milngavie there in the distance then, is it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Have you walked up this way before, or?
No, I haven't. I've walked from Milngavie all the way up to Port William.
So you've done the West Highland Way?
Yeah.
Did you enjoy the West Highland Way?
Okay.
Yeah. So have you only done it once, Si?
Yeah.
Are you going to go back and do it again? Or would you rather do something for it somewhere else?
I'd rather do other various walks.
Yeah. The West Highland Way is alright, but there's only so many times you can enjoy it.
Yeah.
There's plenty more walks in Scotland to enjoy, you know. But this is a fine addition to the West Highland Way. You know, you may as well start from the town, from the city centre. Is that right, Mr. Globetrotter?
That's right, Mr. Hill.
Aye, so we're at Prescott Bridge now. I'm excited to know that the bridge was dedicated to the memory of Sergeant Jim Prescott. That's nice to know. Right, so you want to stop, have some tea?
Yeah, fine.
Oh, is that about a mile to go? I think.
Yeah.
Coming along now. Yeah, so I think this is us approaching Milngavie now. Sports club here, tennis, I think it is. So we're just passing the tennis courts and the golf course on the other side. Just about in Milngavie. Well, come here in May, 7th of May, if you like tennis and you'll have a fun filled day. That's what's on here at Easter and on the 7th of May. Is that right, Mr. Globetrotter?
That's right.
Is that right?
That's correct. Yes. Yeah. Scotland over.
Sports Club. Don't know what park this is. Well, we've reached it, have we, Jason, Mr. Globetrotter? Yeah? We've reached Tesco. Tesco here at Milngavie. There's the river here with lots of shopping trolleys. This is where people stick. If you're not happy with Tesco, this is where you put your trolley. Noticed a few of them in the river. So yeah, if you're not happy with Tesco's prices, bring your trolley down here and throw it in the river. Take your anger out in the trolley, not on the staff. It's not their fault. So if you're coming here to do the West Highland Way, Mr. Globetrotter, yeah? Globetrotter. So this is, so if you come to the West Highland Way, come here first. You go to Tesco. Tesco first.
Every little helps.
It does indeed, every little helps. I prefer Sainsbury's myself. I like to live for less myself. But so you go up here and then you go to Iceland. And then after Iceland you start the West Highland Way, basically. Right, Mr. Globetrotter,
yeah.
He's getting some nice views. Well, here we are, back at Milngavie. This is where I'd started the West Highland Way from. Back on October. Is that right, Mr. Globetrotter? Brings back some memories.
Yeah.
For me. Well, what year was it you did the West Highland Way? Is it 2013?
Yeah.
Aye. So I've done it three times now myself, but my third time was last year. Don't think I'll be doing it again. Where's he going? We're not doing the West Highland Way.
Oh.
Well, you can do it if you want.
I thought we were doing it.
No, not today. Next time, maybe we'll come back and do it another time. Anyway, that's us. We got to Milngavie and now we're going to get the train and head back to Glasgow.
The bus?
Well, the bus, the train, whatever. So that's us heading off. And one last look at Milngavie.